this could be the go, guys. Seriously, go and have a look at the MT450. But yeah, look, I'm pretty happy with that. That's not too bad. I'm a little bit of a fan. That sounds awesome. Back out at KTM Newcastle, speak to the lads down here regarding the CF Moto MT450. Pretty excited about this. I know it's got some pretty high demand at the moment, so much so that there's not many available. There's a long list, so I thought I might be quite keen to throw a leg over one and go and give it a run. Okay, TFT screen's nice. This is easily adjustable. Just flick those mirrors around. That's all good there. Yeah, right. Adjustable clutch. Oh, nice. How's that note? So all the electronics are up. Revs nicely. Oh, it sounds great. Ooh, something I've noticed straight away is the the seating position. That seat feels really low. Yeah, it's a very low seat indeed. Let's drop this sucker down. Let's go for a hoot, gonna have a little bit of fun on the CF Moto standing position. Looks good. It feels comfy around the tank. So the first thing I've noticed is seating. I'm around 180 centimeters. And I have no idea what my inseam is. Oh, that's a nice machine. I reckon you could do some pretty long trips on this and be quite comfortable. You can sit right up close. Yeah, that's good. Well, let's go and have a quick squeeze, see what it's like. Of course, we're on the test rides to go and look for a new bike. And of course, most of the dealers around here, they don't like you going off-road, so we can't do any off-road tests. It is literally going to be get a feel for it on the road and see what she's like. I like this though, this is good. My, because of my long legs, I do get sore knees if they're right up tight. This used to be my old riding grounds. Brakes feel quite positive, third gear. I love that exhaust. ABS on and off, look at that. How easy is that to be able to flick that off on the go? That would be awesome for the off-road rider, without a doubt. Up and over the bump. Yeah, standing position, very, very comfortable. I'll probably say the standing position's more comfortable than the sitting position. We're just gonna go for a quick blast up the road here. You can really tuck your knees in and squeeze that tank. Great machine. Suspension feels a bit on the squishy side, so some adjustment there may be required. So you're just going to do an urban runabout. Yeah, you could very comfortably cruise around. There's no wind here inside, so that's pretty comfortable. Fair bit of wind on the shoulders, but the only reason I know that is because it's quite cool today. Very flicky little machine, I do like it. Very lightweight, but it feels big. This tank's huge. So I don't know what this does. Should we flick through the electronics while we're on the road? That's doing trip meter, odometer. Oh, okay. Yeah, range. Fuel consumption, 3.2 per 100 Ks. That's not bad, that's the immediate. The average is 4.6. Cool, and the top one, trip and odometer, 384 Ks on it. Pretty good, I like it. Feel a lot of wind in these arms. Mirrors are good, a little bit of vibration, but not heaps. sixth gear, trying to keep it on the speed limit, but she does want to get up and go. She's quite keen to move. Oh, this would be a great fun bike on the road. And off-road, I can imagine it would be an absolute hoot. Now, I had to ask the lads at KTM Newcastle about the tyres. It seems like Chinese have done a cheap spin-off of the Pirelli STR. So I don't know how much faith I've got in their rubber. They buy our steel. Wonder where they get their rubber from. Oh, dear. That's pretty cool. I do like it. I'm a little bit keen. Could this be the replacement bike? The seating position's the one thing that's got me. I feel like I need to be up a little bit higher, but I'm sitting in the bike at the moment, not on it. Brakes are very positive. Okay, let's just go for a quick dart down here. There's a bit of dirt there. No. All right, down to the pontoon. All right, let's have a quick look. Yep. It's not bad. Very light, very nimble. You can see it's quite soft in the suspension. Good fender. You've got, some pretty solid fairings on it. LED lights. These handguards are good, but you know they won't last long. I know that you can get some good protection for it. Definitely want to upgrade that bash plate there. This exhaust note. I don't know if I'd even touch that for a 450. I think that is actually not too bad. Good little rack on the back. I'm impressed. I'm really impressed. So if you're looking at getting into the adventure bike market, this could be the go, guys. Seriously, go and have a look at the MT450. And even those that are looking for a lighter bike like I am, I think that could be a winner. So, yeah, why not? Have a quick look, see what your thoughts are. I like it. For anyone who's just out there looking for the average rider's experience, that's what I'm going to give you here. It's, it's good. Single caliper on the front. I don't know, maybe it's just the weight of the bike, the way that is. Jay Juan, so they got their own brakes, full ABS. The electronic suite looks pretty good. I just wish that seat was a little bit higher. But there you go, that's the CF Moto MT450. I don't mind that at all. I reckon you could do it and have a lot of fun with it. Hey lads, so this is it, the Honda Transalp. We're going to go for a bit of a blast on this one today. Great looking bike. Throw a leg over and straight away the first thing I feel is how light it is. Well, it's nice. I can see why Pete likes this so much. Make sure these mirrors are all good to go. And I'll bend that up a little bit. Yeah, not bad. Good size tank there. So we're just going to go for a hoot, check it all out, enjoy the ride a little bit. We've picked the worst day to come out for a ride because we've got all these strong wind warnings and all this crap to deal with, which is going to be pretty nasty. Ooh, a light throttle response. Just in the standard mode at the moment. Nice. Yeah, it's very, very breezy today. I think we're expecting winds of like 100 and 110 k an hour. Cool, these guys are coming in. Alrighty. So the Honda Transalp. This is a consideration. Just let me bend that down just a smidge. And I'll apologise for any wind noise because it is absolutely howling through here at the moment. Nice day for it though, isn't it? It's a good seating position. It feels pretty comfy. It feels long, but comfortable, if you can kind of get my drift. Not too shabby at all. Yeah, truck coming. We'll just start around here. No one coming. All right. Got some nice get up and go. It's got a good note to it. I like it. Yeah, it's pretty good. Love that throttle response. Now, we've got rain mode, gravel, user, and sport. Cool. Oh, that wind is atrocious. How good is that? That's pretty flash indeed. Love the note. Note's really nice. You got all your standard settings on this thing as well, the traction control and everything else, so that's not too bad. But we'll just have a quick sticky beak up here. Yeah, nice, good seat, comfy seat, pretty much near flat foot. I mean, look, if you want to go back to Honda, this is certainly a serious contender without a doubt. So certainly something to think about, so it's just nice to get out there. But yeah, look, I'm pretty happy with that. That's not too bad. Nice, fun bike, but for me at the moment, it feels like it's missing something. First thing I noticed on the road is it's just missing something. Anyhow, that was a nice short run. Not bad, not bad at all. Let's try something. Alrighty, the Desert X, we're out here at Fraser's in Newcastle. And gonna give this Desert X a bit of a run, see what she's like. Certainly up there with the choices. Engine's on already, that's nice. And flat foot, that's good. Mirrors, that's sweet. Yeah, cool. What are we in touring mode at the moment? Let's go and give this girl a run. Ooh, straight away I'm like, yeah, that's nice. Wow, that does feel nice. All right. Oh, dang. The seat is very, very comfy. So 22 litre tank, Kurt was saying. I like the setup here of the TFT. Very easy to go through and get your mode sorted. You got cruise control. Yeah, getting a feel for where the clutch and brake are. It's a bit of a stretch for the fingers, that's for sure. So we're just going to duck across Stockton, out towards Stockton Way. Have a bit of a run. Have a bit of fun with this. Very easy to access cruise control. Fourth gear. Up nice and easy. My wrist still hurts, so it's a bit of an exaggerated maneuver to get the indicators on, which is a bit frustrating. This seating position is perfect. The legs are in a great position. The screen feels okay. No, I can feel the wind just at the top. Just at the top of the helmet there, a little bit of vibration on the peak, so you know it's hitting. It's it feels so well balanced. That's the first thing. Comfortable, good positioning, balance. Standing up is very natural. Can squeeze those legs into the tank. That's nice. Yeah, right. Of course, it's a Ducati, so you're going to be paying top dollar. That's one of the big downsides, I think, with things like Ducati, is that it's going to be expensive to maintain and run. But we'll see. We shall see, I think. Fair bit of wind coming over. That wind's picking right up now. I like the cruise control. Yeah, like well balanced. That feels pretty good. It's still a very long bike. So kind of like still on par with the Africa Twin. This actually feels pretty nice. I'm tell you what, tough contender with the KTM. Real tough contender. I have got no qualms throwing a leg over this and adding this girl to the garage. None whatsoever. I am really impressed. Wow, I did not expect this at all. Not at all. Quick shifters, awesome. So I got no one behind. Down into second. Yeah, that's a nice quick shifter. That is, tell you what, that's a hard choice. Pegs are nice. Everything's good. Yeah, everything's feeling pretty good with this. I will not lie. It's a very, very nice machine indeed. A bit of wind coming over. I'm going to try and find a spot that we can just pull over at and have a quick look at it. All right. I'm just going to stop for a moment. And I'm not going to lie, I'm a little bit of a fan. That sounds awesome. It looks good. I love the color scheme. That looks amazing. It feels really nice. You've got what I call the tampon as a pigeon seat. That feels a bit firm, but I don't think the wife's going to be coming riding with me anytime soon, so that's all right. I'm pretty sure we'll get away with that. Okay, this is definitely a contender. Oh yeah. Couple of F35s for your afternoon. '70 zone. I'm liking it. Yeah, a bit of a fan. All right, the Desert X, tell you what, she's up there. This is a real contender. Good range, still lighter than the Twin. It's very comfortable. My legs feel good on this. The windshield's good. So for the average rider, your average everyday rider, I feel really, really comfortable on this thing. I think the Desert X is certainly going to be up there. With my two contenders after riding the 890, the Transalp and the MT450, the CF Moto contender as well. This is looking pretty good. I will not lie, the Desert X, what to do, what to do.